Be nice or card
reinstate Rafe.
Be nice or
card
reinstate Rafe.
Be nice or card reinstate Rafe.
Jessica, we're here to support Rafe. We want him to come back to the school. We need him. He's not an usual teacher. He's a mentor. That's what he is for us. We need him. He has done so many things for our kids. He makes a difference. We really need him here.
And why would they try to get rid of him? Sounds like he's a star teacher. He's helping so many students. I mean, it's.
I have no idea, to be honest. They haven't talked to us. They haven't told us anything. Everything we know, it's because we're reading the news, we're checking the internet, but they haven't told us anything. They said that it's all about the kids, that they're doing it because of our kids, but they don't tell us anything. Nobody has sent us a letter. Nobody has to give us a call, nothing. We're just waiting.
Is that respectful?
They do dance, they sing, they perform. They, other than the regular academics, other than the math, most of his kids are very advanced, most of them, and it's because of the program. And I'm really, really happy that my son is here because he's doing so many things that he didn't do before. He's 100% better than he was before. Yeah.
David Mendieta. My family first heard about Rafe around 1999 when my sister came here to Hobart. She wasn't part of Rafe's class, but she had heard of the program and everything. And that got my parents motivated to put my older brother into the Hobart Shakespeare program, 2004, Hamlet. And so because of that, because of the way they changed my brother's life, they decided to put me in it. And I was part of the play in 2009, 2010. Yeah.
What play was this?
The Merchant of Venice and the Comedy of Errors. Right. Yeah.
And what's it like working with Rafe? Why do you feel so that he should be out here picketing for us?
Well, when I was younger, he did teach us a lot of things, but it never really hit me. Mainly because I had never really grasped the concept of, I don't know, of acting as an adult, even though I was younger. However, looking back now that I'm in high school, I've realized now that he's taught me some very valuable lessons, things that I never would have learned even in a private school, you know, or honesty, responsibility, or, you know, integrity or initiative.
Right. And why would this happen to him? Sounds like he's a star teacher, he's gotten all these awards.
Right, that's what I kept asking myself, you know. I recently moved to South Central, LA, so I hadn't been in touch with him, but I had been keeping up through articles or through, you know, people who still live in Koreatown, and, you know, it really appalled me that this would happen to such a great teacher, right? And I don't know why this is happening, but I know that this will all end soon, or at least I hope, so that he can come back and at least, you know. Yeah.
What do you think about the charter schools? You think that's a solution to what's going on with Los Angeles education?
Rafe has talked about charter schools when I was in his class. I don't remember very well what he said, but I mean, the fact of the matter is, public schools are still very important. I don't think we should abandon them just to go to another system. I feel like we should just work from within, as Rafe was doing before. But we need people who actually support, I guess, this at least Rafe's ideology. Because from what I heard, the board of the directors for the LAUSD opposed what he thought.
My name is Ben Mycelis.
Okay.
I'm one of the attorneys for Rafe Esquith. And I was informed that students and parents, former and current, who wanted to be current students of Rafe Esquith, were going to have a rally here today. And I just wanted to see the groundswell of support that Rafe has. And I wanted to be here as Rafe's counsel to report that to him. And what's so shocking to me is the imagery here. You have students who know Rafe more than anyone. You have parents who know Rafe more than anyone. The community who knows Rafe more than everyone. And you have police department locking down a school when the request today is incredibly simple. And the request today is, we want to talk to the principal to reinstate Rafe, but the principal is refusing to show. We have LAUSD people here reporting back what's going on. LAUSD doesn't understand the first rule of holes, which is stop digging. And the more and more LAUSD continues to make up allegations, the more and more a complaint is filed.
New allegations?
Every time a complaint is filed, LAUSD comes up with something incredibly ridiculous, from a Huck Finn quote to permission slips to a financial audit 15 years of somebody's life. And they're timed the day after a complaint is filed, smack, there's a retaliation. And we all know this is just a complete joke. It's LAU.
A lot of money is being spent trying to fight this complaint to get him back in the classroom. Does he want to go back in the classroom?
Rafe loves his students more than anything. And it's kind of shocking to me that he would even want to go back given the amount of abuse he's been. But Rafe is this figure that is beyond comprehension what he's done. He's already turned down seven-figure jobs, schools that have the Rafe Esquith school name on it, to be a public school education teacher. But you know what? Rafe's story isn't unique to him. And what's shocking is that we've got, since Rafe's story became public, we've received about 1,000 phone calls from other teachers who want to be represented, who tell the identical story. Some of those teachers are here today, but the story is the same. LAUSD makes up the same exact types of allegations. LAUSD defames teachers. Teachers commit suicide because their entire dignity is deprived of them. And you want to know what I trust? I trust 1,000 people who dedicated their lives to public education at a salary of $50,000 a year. Who I don't trust is people like Superintendent Cortinas, who paid out $200,000 in settlements for grabbing people's crotches, who have side deals with Scholastic Inc., who previously covered up the Miramonte scandal and now have the same law firm that covered up that scandal now investigating teachers who affirmatively hid photographs. And so if you want to know who I trust the teachers, 1,000 teachers. I know that those, and there's one here, and there's a lot of teachers here who say the exact same thing happened
so this
to me.
It's not unique what's happening.
It's not unique, and now what's going to happen is a movement's going to start. And you're watching the very first steps of that movement today.
Well, there's a Board of Education. There's a lot of people who are supposed to be doing oversight. Why is this continued to seemingly go out of control? I mean, it sounds like it's completely out of control here. There's nobody in charge. I mean, is this...
Since the Cortinas, DZ, and now Cortinas administration... Well, since those three regimes were in power, they got away with it. And all that money that they got from firing teachers went back into their pockets. It went to their pockets because it goes to corporations. It goes to the iPad program. It goes to the school audit program. It goes to all these failed programs. That's where that money goes. And then they sit on the boards of these organizations. I mean,
there's a financial conflict of interest.
I'm saying I wouldn't be the first person to call that out. Well, I'm the first of many things that would not be the first would not be the first thing there, but. Look, what we have here are students. You have young elementary students whose lives were forever changed by Rafe. And this is about the students. And we don't want Superintendent Cortinas, who made settlement payouts for crotch grabbing, and we don't want that regime telling us what's in the best interest of students, okay?
Where is the union? It's UTLA?
Well, I can tell you this. My number one priority is representing all the teachers who come to me. That's my approximately 1,000.
You represent 1,000 teachers?
Yes. It's going to be the largest class action in the history of public education.
1,000 teachers?
Probably more after today. I'll check my voicemail, but it's probably full.
So what you're saying are that many of these senior teachers, you think they're getting rid of teachers because of their seniority?
There's going to be various classes, but the main class, when I say classes, in a class action complaint, there's subclasses. One of the classes that exist, obviously, are teachers in the upper age, reaching retirement, whose benefits are taken, stripped, and by getting rid of them. You put them in teacher jail, you have them linger.
People tried to see the principal and They weren't able to see the principal?
I think that what you need to do is call Shannon Haber, who's the director of communications, and she'll have most up-to-date information.
There's an issue of bullying, workplace bullying against teachers. Do you think there's an epidemic of workplace bullying in Los Angeles Unified School District?
I would ask that you call Shannon Haber, who is our director of communications, to be able to help.
You're not with the communications department?
Yes, I am, but Shannon will be able to provide you with any information.
Okay. What's your name?
I'm Barbara Jones.
Be nice, work hard, reinstate, great.
Jeff Scher. I'm a retired LAUSD teacher. As of June 5th, they closed my program with adults with disabilities. I had some false allegations thrown against me without any proof at all, nothing substantial at all. And I was put into a short-term teacher jail, into a room to sit for a while. I was accused of things that I just did not do. I talked to David Hemquote, talked to general counsel at LAUSD. They threw it right out of their office because it was nothing. Yet, after it was thrown out of the office, my vice principals, principal and vice principal at Manual Arts Adult School, were told by central office, hey, harass Jeff Scher some more, bother him some more. Because I'm tenured and because I have seniority, and if the district, like the attorney just told you, can save money off senior teachers, they're closing program and save the money. That's all they care about.
So you think it's a financial incentive for them to get rid of senior teachers?
Of course I do, yes.
And do you know others that this has happened to?
Yes, I do.
It's a similar kind of thing?
Similar kind of thing, just false allegations with no proof. And with the responses that I wrote, I got out of teacher jail. I was one of the teachers that got out. I got out in a couple weeks because they couldn't prove anything. And when I went down to the Bouldery building, they had a big meeting about me at the Bouldery building, which is the school district, about what happened with me, the false allegations.
What did they do?
Well, they were just saying, well, let's get them. Let's find some way to get them. So they ended up giving me a reprimand notice, which was non-disciplinary at the bottom because there was nothing they could do.
So they gave you a reprimand notice because they had nothing else.
Yeah, that's not.
After they put you in the jail.
And I got out, they gave me a reprimand notice, and then I sent the reprimand notice downtown too with my response saying there's not one bit of allegation. I asked you numerous times for any proof, any substantial proof that I did anything. And they couldn't find anything. So they had a big meeting downtown, and they quickly put me back into my classroom, and I found an internal memo from my principal's office that said, put Jeff Scher back in the classroom right now. He's been calling downtown. He called everybody. He even called the superintendent of schools. And that just bothered him. And when I went down to the Bouldery building, I was teaching adult education. I talked to the secretary at adult ed, and, oh, you're Jeff Scher? She goes like this. I'm glad that's finished with. Because I shook that whole building like an earthquake.
Well, why would this be going on? There's so many.
Because they want to save their darn money.
And where's the money going?
As the attorney just told you, to iPad programs and to things that are not educational.
You think business are profiting off of this?
Of course they are. Of course they are.
And what do you think about DAISY privatization charters, which are...
I don't necessarily believe in it. I think if we got a good school board that was really involved, because all the times I was called the school board myself, they never called me back. I have never been able to talk to a school board member my whole time.
No.
It's always a secretary.
Now, what about
the union,
UTLA?
What? Union's been good. It could be a lot stronger, though.
Did they file a grievance for your...
After I got out of teacher jail, the district told me to do a long-term lesson plan. Like a 6-month lesson plan for my class, and the union said it's not in the collective bargaining agreement, so I don't have to do it. So I fought that. I did the long-term lesson plan because you have to follow orders from your supervisor if I work any place. But then after that, I grieved it with the union, and I won. So after I grieved it, I beat them twice, basically, and then so that all they could do is close my program to retire me. They couldn't hurt me because I...
So you were forced to retire by closing your program?
Yeah. Luckily I had that rule of 80, which is your age plus your years of service have to add up to 80 to get your retirement benefits and your pension.
But there are a lot of teachers that haven't been able to do that.
Yeah, some of them got really in financial straits. They got hurt.
How does that affect the teachers who are being bullied by kids and
Well, it's horrible. I mean, people get depressed and they can't pay their bills and they're kicked out. They lose their health insurance. You have to retired during active pay to get your health insurance.
So it's kind of like terrorism against teachers.
That's a strong word. That's a very good word. It's just harassment, bullying, and harassment.
And you think that's one of the reasons there's a decline, there's a shortage of teachers now?
Well, there obviously is because of this. Obviously.
You got young people don't want to go into the teaching profession.
No, obviously.
This is what's happening to teachers?
Yeah.
I mean, why has there been, 1,000 teachers, the attorney said, now are involved in this lawsuit?
Because the same thing happened to them that happened to me. The exact same thing. Bullying, harassment, unfair memos, you know, allegations that aren't true. If you teach, you come to work, you clock in, you do your job, you go home, that's what they want. Cookie cutter type of approaches. So if you're creative or you tell a joke or do anything like that, that upsets the scale.
But I thought that's what they wanted in the charters, you know, creative new forms of education.
I could go into charters, but with
charters... Why don't you go into it? What is it?
Well, the difference between charters is that there's no job security, first of all. There's no... no job security. Second of all, there's no... could be no medical benefits, no pension, nothing to protect teachers. You can get kicked out at any time you want. Now, with a union, with a union job, the union has protections for teachers.
So
and you have to go
through
your procedure and
so
process.
Autocratic.
Yeah, it's not autocratic.
Teachers have been retaliated against in charter schools? Or
no, I haven't. No, but I called a charter school once, and they wouldn't touch me because I don't have a PhD.
A charter school wouldn't touch you, but they take PFAs?
They want people with PhDs, yeah. It's a whole mess.
The elder teachers.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So they're not respecting the senior teachers?
Olympia. Yeah, I'm here to support my nephew, David Mendieta. He has been on Rafe's class.
And how has he been affected by being in Rafe's class?
Very good, very good. I know that.
This is like helping him.
Yes. Uh-huh. His parents, they couldn't come because they're working, but I came because I go work later. I think they are, Rafe, he spends a lot of his time helping these kids, and I think they don't like that. He deserves this respect because he has spent a lot of years in this school. I've been living close by. I was living here, and when we passed here going to work at 6 a.m., the van was already there outside. When we come back from work 5, the van's still there outside. So he spent a lot of... It's very disappointing. Yeah, it's very disappointing.
This is a community school.
It is, and he's helping mostly, this area. It's like very low-income kids. It's not like he's doing his best. This kind of teachers is what we need here in this area. So we must have him back. Necesitamos que regrese el maestro Rafe Esquith a enseñar en esta escuela porque los niños lo necesitan.
These are given to the students who participate in the play and anyone who donates to the Hobart Shakespearean Foundation.
And this is what was going on at this school because of Ray?
He was responsible for this after-school program whereby the kids would perform in a complete unabridged Shakespeare play every year for the last 25 years. The person who did the printing donated their services. My husband did the photos, I did the graphics. But it shows that the kids have a complete understanding of the material. It's such a bonus to them to understand by doing the best that the English language has to offer, which is Shakespeare, because it has so many modern elements when you get beyond some of the intricacies of the language. Drama, love, history, all the emotions. So,
I know I had a... I mean, it sounds like he was making major contributions.
He was. They have picked absolutely the wrong person to go after. This is like going after Dr. Albert Schweitzer or Mother Teresa. It's like no good deed goes unpunished. He's given so much to this public school class over the last 25 years. I have no answers as to why. It's deplorable. They My personal suspicion is it's sort of like the IRS. They don't like to admit they're wrong. They want to justify their man hours, so they keep digging deeper, even though they're not getting what they want.
Hi, my name's Annie Hahn, and I'm a parent at Hobart. My son will be a fifth grader this year. Rafe is this amazing man who works tirelessly and endless hours giving to this community through his classroom 56. He inspires the children to aspire for more than maybe what they grew up with. He wants them to see the world through books and also by taking them, you know, on these amazing trips. My daughter got to go to Washington, D.C. last year, and shows them not just through stories, but actually showing them the monuments and showing them the history and saying, America is a great nation and you can be an awesome citizen who gives back to the community as well. That's what he does. And he does it through Shakespeare. My daughter started coming here at fourth grade. And so she was here for 2 years. And then my son has been with Rafe for 2 years.
So what is this all about? I mean, it sounds like he's a star teacher. And
this is a witch hunt. We don't know.
It's a witch hunt.
It's a witch hunt. We don't
know. How has it been a witch hunt?
Because there's nothing to validate these allegations, right? There's not one piece of evidence that shows no parent, no child has ever complained about Rafe. And so where is this coming from? It's a witch hunt. I mean, I think, honestly, LAUSD is afraid because of what happened with Miramonte, and now this other teachers are getting the backlash of it. Yeah, it's not fair.
I mean, what is this going to do to education if teachers like him are retaliated against?
No, exactly.
And he's a star teacher. He's nationally known. I mean,
exactly.
What does that say to the teachers
exactly.
who are left there?
Exactly.
How are they going to?
No, I mean, it's basic bullying, right? It's puts a fear in you, and it's scary because I don't want teachers to hold back on, you know, what they love and want to share with the children because of the bullying, because of, you know, what could happen to them. Yeah.
So this bullying,
do you think it's happening to other teachers besides Rafe?
Oh, yes. I have a lot of friends who are teachers and, you know, whatnot, and
what's
they've shared
same things or
same kind of things. Yeah, allegations based on nothing, based on no evidence. And yet they get sent to either teacher jail or they get dismissed or sent to another
school. What is this teacher jail?
You know, honestly, I don't know. It's a mystery. It's this, yeah, until, you know, Rafe actually spoke out about it, I didn't know. Well, he said that he, you know, in what his lawyer sent out, it said that he was sent to teacher jail. And that's how we found out.
No,
you don't know that he's being, it's terrible. It's terrible. You hear that a teacher suspended, you think maybe they're at home or, you know, teacher jail. That's ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
And the Board of Education, the superintendent, they all know about this. Have they been asked what's going on here? I mean,
went to the school board and we talked to our school board members. Our kids were able to, you know, give a little speech, but I mean, they haven't responded. There's no response. They just say no comment to everything right now.
What does that say about education? It seems like it's...
They say it's their priority, but, you know, if what they're saying... Because they're saying children before adults. But if our children are saying Rafe is providing the best education, but they're keeping him away from them, it just doesn't make any sense. Education doesn't seem to be their priority at this point.
What is their priority?
I don't know. That's the scary thing.
What about charter schools? What do you think about that? Do you think there's any relationship with what's going on here? It seems like...
I have no idea. I don't know what that relation... Yeah, what the correlation might be with that, yeah. I just know my son is supposed to be in Rafe's class tomorrow, and he's not. So Rafe's not back. So
you know, Rafe is clip back in our community, in the Hobart School, because I can notice when my son was in the fifth grade, and they didn't finish with Mr. Esquith, so we noticed totally different, you know. The grades and everything, you know, they gonna go to the sixth grade, but I think like we send it like the war with no arms, you know, that's what we noticed because we really need the teacher back.
So this Rafe, he was doing a very good job for you.
Absolutely, I think he's one of the best teachers, and you know, for Los Angeles University School District. I can say it because I have a daughter that she's already in college, and she studied hard, you know, because of him, and also my this a former student is gonna be in sixth grade. And his name is Emmanuel Quapio. He was in, you know, one of the plays. And I know that we really need back, you know, Rafe Esquith in school.
So he really inspires the students.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I think he's, you know, he can be with, you know, all his knowledge, to a better place, but he decided to stay in our, you know, community. You know, they're like, it's a low income, you know. And he teach to the parents, you know, how to work hard, you know, to.
So this is the kind of teacher you need in this community.
Absolutely.
Somebody we really need. Give everything.
Yeah.
To.
That's why we are here, you know, and we are everywhere. Then, you know, whatever we need to do, we're gonna do because we need it back.
And why would the school district management target somebody like this, who's a star teacher, he's nationally known, the students love him? What is going on?
Because I think, you know, the superintendent, they don't care about us. They just care about the, you know, the salaries and everything. But we really, you know, they have to think about it, you know, about what the school need and, you know, how the teachers need it. Really, I got no idea why, but we don't need a younger or, you know, we need Rafe. That's all we need right here. I think that's why this school is one of the best schools in, you know, our community, because of him.
Because of what he's done here. And what is the program? What has he done here? What kind of program is
well,
it?
Well, they've been teaching, you know, like a lot of, you know, things, like the people they can see in, you know, like junior high. They've been teaching in, you know, elementary school. That's why they prepare for the college. I can tell you because my daughter, she's in college already. She's going to be in their third year.
And because of?
Oh, because of him. And she was on the play too.
She was inspired by him.
Yes.
This is Paul Kim.
And what's going on here today?
What we're doing is we're doing a little protest, a little rally to reinstate Rafe into the LAUSD, especially into room 56, where he used to teach before. Yeah. What LAUSD is doing right now to Rafe is kind of horrible. It's really unjust.
What are they doing to him?
They're making more and more allegations on him. They're saying, first, we need to look at your financial records. Now they're saying, we looked through your email, we saw some really inappropriate stuff, and everyone is like, wait, why are you guys going over this? And why are we prolonging this kind of mess? And that's why we're here. Like about a month ago, we were in front of the Hobart Boulevard parking lot. We were just protesting. Other news came in, and we're saying why we're here and what kind of, why this kind of thing is happening, all because of a Mark Twain quote, and now we're doing this again. Yeah.
Sounds unbelievable.
Yeah, it is.
That they would spend all this money trying to go after him. And,
exactly,
and
yeah.
The students, teachers want him back. Are they bullying teachers here? Do you think teachers are being bullied?
I mean, like, every time I read the news, right, more about Rafe, and then I see in the comment section a lot of teachers saying, Rafe is not just the only one. He's one of the more well-known teachers, but it's happening in LAUSD right now. So I became a little more known to this, yeah, just recently.
Why would they be going after people like that?
I am not very sure of the news, but I think very recently there was a child abuse kind of happening in another public school, and so LAUSD is like, we need to bump our game up a bit.
And yeah. This is a school in a working class, poor community, Latino,
yes.
Black. I mean, these are the kind of students that would need somebody like Rafe.
Yeah.
I mean, are they thinking about this, or I mean, what?
I mean, the community, of course, is like, why are you guys taking out one of the best teachers in LAUSD? I mean, when I got accepted to that class, I was overjoyed. And when I was in that class, a lot of life-changing moments happened in there. And now that they took away Rafe, I'm very sure the parents and the students, they're not very happy about this.
And yeah. How did he affect you as a student?
Oh, man. It's, in a lot of ways, yeah. He taught me about life skills, how to organize my time. He taught me about money skills. We had jobs in the classroom. We always had things to do. Like, many people would usually just go play out during recess, but we would be practicing music. He taught me for the love of music. He taught me a lot of things, yeah. I would have to write them all down. I can't.
Did he change your life?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he did. Yeah.
Sounds like a very important teacher.
He's a very important teacher. I always come by every year, or I try to at least say hi and, you know, talk to the kids and say how lucky you guys are.
So you're pretty angry that they've done this to us.
I am pretty upset, yeah. But more like just shocked. I'm like, okay, I thought this was going to cool down right before school starts, but obviously it did not. So I'm kind of, my dad also is like, what is LAUSD doing? And yeah, we're just more.
You live in LA?
Oh yeah, I live just two blocks away from here, yeah.
And, so the community is pretty upset about this.
I think so, yes.
Maybe you should run for school board.
Oh, man. that would be really good. First priority is to reinstate Rafe. I think that would be if I ran for school board. Yeah.
So, when did you go to school here?
I went to school here, I started like in kindergarten, in the kindergarten program, but I was in Rafe's class during the year of 2009 to 2010.
Helping a student, helping the community, outstanding teacher, but it seems like LAUSD doesn't understand that. It's not supporting good teachers, not supporting senior teachers, people who have been giving their life to the education of children, the care for children. It seems like district is ignoring all those facts. You know?
So, but why? I mean, isn't their job to help the children here? I mean, have teachers like this guy, Rafe, who is a good teacher? I mean, it seems like...
Well, why? I think because we have the wrong people working for the district. People who really don't care, probably people who just want is a paycheck, a big fat paycheck, and they are interested in their own interests. You know, knowing the interest of the children. They are not putting the children first. They are forgetting about our children. They are not putting the main interest for everybody is to have a good education for our children.
And what's your name?
Patricio.
And does your child go to this school?
No, but I've been watching videos on the internet about how his way of teaching, all what he's doing for the community. So you don't have to be, you know, really know the teacher to know what he's doing for many years.
Now, do you think that this is a unique situation or it's happening at other schools where teachers like Ray are being targeted and retaliated against by LAUSD?
I think it's happening in other schools. Yeah, this isn't the only school. If you have friends that are teachers, do you know what's going on or what, you know, do you know their stories? Of course, many of them, or most of them, or all of them, cannot talk about it because, you know, in the way they have confirmed retaliation from the LA district.
And what are these jails? They put people in jails? What's going on with this?
I discovered a teacher jail about probably a month or 3 weeks ago when I read an article in the LA Times. No. I read a UTLA newspaper, and then I saw it in the LA Times. It's shocking. We're living, what, in the 1800s, 1700s? What's going on, you know? I have the same questions that you are asking me. I'm sure many people have them. I have them because nowadays, to be this happening to teachers, and especially outstanding teachers like Rafe, is incredible. I think, you know, in all the systems, it's something good. And I'm not discarding the whole system, but I'm sure of changing some people, you know? People who really care about the children. They put the children first, you know? And after that, you know, we're gonna accomplish a better education for our children. But that's a $1 million question, you know? And not only Rafe, there's many teachers that are spending.
Do you know other teachers that have been in this situation?
I have some friends that are in this situation, more or less in this.
Are they being bullied the same, harassed and bullied?
Yes, they are bullying, harassed, but they cannot talk because, you know, the retaliation, it gets worse in the job placement for them.
Here, I've known Rafe since 1997. Rafe Esquith is an amazing teacher at Hobart. He's been here over 25 years. He is in room 56. He's won the Oprah Use Your Life Award. He's won the Presidential Medal for the Arts. He's currently going over to China to meet with their teachers to inspire. He's written many books. He's had thousands of teachers in this classroom following him. And he's been removed from his classroom and put in LAUSD's teacher jail.
What are the teacher jails? What are they about?
Nice, you guys. As far as I know, it's when there's any kind of accusation, founded or non-founded, unfounded, they are put into this, they have to go to a place during school hours. They're not allowed to look at their computers. They're not allowed to have their phones. And they clock in and clock out, and they're being paid. A substitute is being paid to take over their class. And while these accusations are being investigated, and until, you know, there's some resolution. As of now, even though it was promised that by the end of middle of August there would be a resolution, there has been none. So Rafe will not be here tomorrow teaching where he's meant to be.
What does that say about the Los Angeles School District, LAUSD?
Well, to me it says, and I was a student of LAUSD back in the 50s, it says to me that they're using a lot of taxpayer money. They're hiring outside counsel. They're hiring private investigators. They are, I think, have become totally overreactive to, you know, whatever the accusations may be, and I certainly am not privy to all of them. I know what prompted this. I know the accusation that prompted this was a quote from a Mark Twain book. I mean, I have to laugh because it's laughable. And
what was the quote?
It was from Huckleberry Finn. It had to do with, you know, the king is coming in on all fours. Naked. He used the word naked. Oh my God. And he then went on to say, if we don't raise money to do our play, we may have to do the same. And the kids laughed and they moved on. So
this is the investigation?
That's what started it. Now I think it's a classic witch hunt. I think, you know, then you start to find out, you know, is there anything else? And I don't, you know, it strains credulity that somebody who has been this high profile for this long, who has won these kinds of awards, national, international, that he hasn't been vetted, you know, for any kind of impropriety up until now. It's shocking to me that Superintendent Cortinas has never been in this classroom, even though the school, you know, up until probably now, it's on their webpage, you know, the world-renowned Room 56, Rafe Esquith. And his kids have always done really well on core exams. They've, even after the accusation was made, they had his class take the exam first because they knew they would do well. Rafe is inspiring in the sense that he loves three things. He loves Shakespeare, he loves rock and roll, and he loves baseball. And he used those three things in this classroom to inspire his kids. And his motto was, be nice, work hard. When you go into his classroom, it's covered, well, no longer because they've removed everything and no one knows where it is. I mean, he bought instruments for the kids to learn and to use. It's covered with the pennants of the colleges where these kids are going, have gone, have graduated from. Most of them are first generation in this country. Most of them, English is their second language. Most of them, they're the first generation to go on to college. So the proof is in the pudding.
Do you think the management is trying to destroy public education in Los Angeles by this kind of action? I mean, they're closing schools, they're giving money to charters.
It sounds war against teachers and on one level. I think there's a feeling that, you know, Rafe is 61. I think there's a feeling that as they reach retirement age and they don't want to pay their pensions, that they're, you know, doing whatever they can to remove them and bring in younger, less experienced. I think mediocrity is the name of the game. I think when somebody rises above that, it creates jealousy. It creates, I mean, in some ways, it's amazing he's gone this long without something. I met him because I was working with a woman named Loretta Thomas, who you may remember. Loretta lost her daughter, Corey Williams, in 1997. She was on a city bus going home from school, and a gang member shot through the window in the bus and killed her instantly. Loretta worked in plant management at Hobart, and she said, there's a teacher here, and he's got a nonprofit, and maybe he'll help us get started, because she wanted to start a scholarship fund in her daughter's name. So Rafe, you know, gave of his time, sat, had lunch, and that's when I met him the first time, and he told me what he was doing. I ran an arts organization for kids in New York City. I know how important it is for development. And, you know, more and more as it's being cut from the budget, it's, to me, incredibly important that it be brought back in. And for someone like Rafe, who gave up his weekends, who gave up his summers, who gave up his family life for this, I mean, this is tragic.
What do you think about Eli Broad and his plans for Los Angeles education?
I don't know enough to comment. Okay. I don't know enough to comment.
So what about the union? Are they supporting Rafe?
Hey, Lee could answer this better. What's the union's stance where Rafe is concerned?
I would rather not. But that's okay.
The union stance is that...
Expect somebody to come here and try to go in, or what's happening?
Because of what's going on out here.
We're just watching.
Making sure everything's peaceful,
yeah.
Easy going.
That's it.
Have there been any threats against the school?
And then, like, I don't know when we got
to get the